My name's Guy Speranza, and I'm the costume designer on the Bastard Executioner. The process of creating the wardrobe for the Bastard Executioner is to create a medieval world that is real and dirty and lived in, so you believe that you're living in that world. You read a script, you know, you create sort of, you know, concept boards of their look. Every single character is individual and has their own style.
Action.
You immerse yourself into a world where the more wealthy you were, the more fabrics you had.
I think I would like something with a bit more colour.
And let's find something cheerful.
The reality was that colour was money, so we dumbed down the colours a lot on Wilkin's crew, so the sort of browns and beiges and, you know, greens and blacks and darker colours, and differentiating them to the nobility. I wanted to keep it sort of tonally with golds and yellows and blacks and reds, because red was a very noble colour. We made them look, you know, aged, we dyed them and dipped them. It's part of the process of doing the costume. Everyone in the show has had some treatment done to them.
First thing we do is generally a physical breaking down, which generally involves roughing things up in some way. We paint into things, we spray into things with dye and paint. We add texture and character so that when it's on camera and under lighting, it has a more, you know, a softer effect.
Our man needs a greater challenge.
Guy Speranza went to painstaking lengths to import the right fabrics and costumes. He got costumes from Madrid and France and Morocco, and to put together our costume, which is obviously a big part of establishing the period.